all those files were sent over the wire.
Correct. And so when I sort it, I see that I have my WASM file, this is my font file, and then I have my two laser and mono.js files.
And the DLLs, are those in bytecode?
So these are DLLs because I'm actually running .NET in the browser. So WASM is what gets executed in the browser, but these DLLs are needed for references. And so if you look over in here, when I do page source, and let's increase this a bit, we see that we have the app tag where things are being executed, and then we reference blazor.js, and then we specify that we're going to be using blazordemo.dll with this entry point, and then all these references that go along with it.
So those JavaScript files are doing all of the fun, like the lift command client in the browser, referencing those DLL files.
The JavaScript?
Yeah, like those JavaScript files.
So you just have this blazor.js file, which again, it's pretty easy reading JavaScript right there, right?
It's like a module there. It's all in iffy, so this will run as soon as the browser loads it. And I think it's just pulling every DLL module that needs it.
Right.
That's weird.
Like, is the JavaScript manipulating down the browser?
Is the JavaScript manipulating the DOM?
Yeah.
No, we're not talking on a binary level.
Okay.
So this JavaScript just gets things loaded, and then also in combination with the WASM file.
It's really so like we've shortcutted it around the step of the browser interpreting anything, right? Just pipe right into the browser rendering engine.
Exactly. So you have HTML as a high level, along with JavaScript and CSS, and then you have an interpreter that interprets that HTML and JavaScript and CSS, and then you have WebAssembly. So we're just going straight down to the root of it. Sounds interesting? Okay. I have some business cards up here. I'd be happy to do the demo for them or her.
So if this was to catch on, I mean, what would you estimate? How long would it be till like enterprises could do something like this?
15 years?
Yeah. I mean, that are.
Yeah. Well, first of all, it's got to. It has to come to a production level release, right?
You can be able to debug.
Be able to debug details, right?
Yeah.
The interactive debugging. And then after that, then the education factor comes into play. And if I'm heading up an IT department, how many people within my department can I send to training? And how many people can I hire later that have the skill set? So it's going to take some time. I mean, MVC didn't catch on like fire. It took some time as well.
It seems like the stage is set to stuff that people know enough that's familiar enough. Is it React to stuff that's familiar?
Oh, it's like I can pick out like so many different things. I'm
like back end stuff that it looks familiar with ABC stuff.
Now, not to contradict what I said, you're really learning the framework and how it works. Well, what's the language that you're coding in?
C-sharp.
C-sharp. How many people know C-sharp out there?
Lots.
Especially around here.
Yeah.
So it's just a matter of the framework that's a little bit different. I know we're just wrapping up. Any other last minute questions? Yes, ma'am.
So DLLs, are they machine code or?
So the DLLs, what's happening here, let's take a closer look at it.
They only work through that mono project. You didn't mention that.
Right. Where is my browser?
A view them is being already compiled, but if they're being sent over the wire, then how are they being compiled?
So there's two different things that are being sent over the wire. There are actually several. There is the WASM file, right, the WebAssembly. That's the one that is going to communicate with the browser, right? That just has the functionality to actually do things. But I do have about a dozen or so DLLs here that I've referenced in my C-sharp code that when that WASM file runs, it needs to reference what's in those DLLs. So for example, in the counter, I utilize an integer type. Where is integer defined?
In the counter C-sharp file.
Right, but more importantly, in what library? Where's Integer itself?
.NET or C#.
The system namespace, or the system library, right? So system.dll needs to get downloaded to the browser, because when we run that WASM and we see an Integer type, we need to reference that type from that library. You see what I'm saying?
Okay. Oh, there it is. All right.
So the model is used by Xamarin, that's where it came from, and it's stable and out.
Right. And so is C#.
Right.
Now it's just this framework called Laser that we just need to get to a production level.
So if it doesn't care if it's already on the client, why don't you just reference the system library to the core?
.NET is on the client?
Yeah.
Well, we don't know that for sure.
If it will, or do we caching then?
But then we're right going back to the Silverlight scenario again.
Right. I was wondering how that was used. Because those things aren't built into, like, Mac clients.
Not yet.
So that's just coming straight to the browser from the server.
Well, I take that back. We got, if we look at the browser compatibility, how much time do I have, Andy? I'm sorry, Josh.
Oh, this is not going to take
5-6 minutes.
Okay.
This is not going to take ground unless they can do support with mobile apps. Well, yeah, with the Android it doesn't.
Right.
Samsung it doesn't.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it works.
In Chrome?
I have it up on Chrome right here.
In the browser?
Yeah, it works.
You mean an app?
Chrome on everything, yeah.
Yeah.
That's the old school stock Android thing that's been dead. That was good.
So I have UC browser for Android. And on Chrome for Android, version 66, that supports it. Samsung Internet Browser, version 6.2, that's not supported. And much to everyone's shock, IE version 11 is not supported. Sorry, I have to throw that one in there. The whole thing is a wash, forget it.
About AOL browser?
I'm sorry?
Is that AOL browser?
Can't hear you.
AOL browser. AOL.
I was just kidding.
I actually came across someone who has an AOL email. I
was like, wow. I came across.
Really?
Yeah.
I have a client that's a law firm downtown, and one of the computers that I went on to do some work for them, and they said, AOL browser? She goes, yeah, I'm not switching.
Please tell me when you get an email that says you've got mail.
Yeah, I know.
So there's my contact information. I welcome you to connect with me on LinkedIn or Twitter. If you have any questions, my email is snasser@nistechnologies. I also have business cards here. If any questions should arise later. What I'd like to do is to pass out these email forms and would be open to your honest feedback as to what you thought of the presentation and any improvements that you'd like to see, as well as any future topics for that matter. Thank you. Yes, sir.